Hi everyone, welcome to another Scars of Mirrodin draft here. Got a kind of interesting pack here. The main standouts, of course, are Putrefax and Galvanic Blast. With, I guess, a Rustic and a Dark Citric kind of looking on from the sidelines. I think taking Putrefax first over Galvanic Blast is committing a little more than I'd like to. I mean, even if you like poison, that's still kind of a commitment, though. I mean, if you really want to draft poison, that is certainly a fine pick. Putrefax is, I think, a little worse than Cisbear, and I think Cisbear and Galvanic Blast are close, so I wouldn't say that was a terrible pick. I don't like opening with Putrefax. I'd rather open with Galvanic Blast, which probably comes as not much of a surprise. All right, and following it up with not a whole lot here. Same uncommon runner, a similar one with both the Drake and the Tick. This time the common's gone. There's no real cards pointing us in any direction. I do like Dark Citric. I think Dark Citric's the best card in the pack, but Rustic keeps us a lot more open and is also going to be quite a fine card. So I think I'd rather be a little flexible and take the Rustic. This next pack leaves us with a Trigon of Corruption. I like Palladium Mirror, but Trigon of Corruption is really good, so getting one third is pretty awesome. Still don't really know what colors we are, but we've got a pretty good start of three removal spells. Alright then, so there's a Plague Stinger, a Tangle Angler, an Ikraclaw Mirror, so poison seems pretty open. There's also a Nurok Replica and some weaker cards. I'm not going to take Nurok Replica or Origin Spell, I don't think. Now the question is, if I want to take a poison card, which one do I take? And I think I take Tangle Angler. Tangle Angler, I think, is the best card in this pack, and it's the best in a non-poison deck, because Ikraclaw Mirror and Plague Stinger obviously don't do much if you don't end up poison, but Tangle Angler is actually fine in a just like a red-green deck. But if I took Tangle Angler, I'd be looking to draft either Poison Splash and Galvanic Blast, Poison not playing Galvanic Blast, or just red-green. So, but I think getting a fourth pick Tangling with all those other cards in the pack is somewhat of a signal. So now the question is whether I want to keep drafting Poison and take Icarats or take something like Alpha Tyrannax or Ratchet Bomb. I think I'm just going to take Icarats. It looks like Poison's open and all our cards go fine in Poison, and even if we don't end up playing the Blast, it's not a huge deal. The guy to our left is almost assuredly Poison considering we passed him Putrefax and some other poison guys, but that doesn't matter too much if the guy to our right is shipping us poison. So, alright, Blight Mamba, an easy pick here. Even though Horizon Spellbomb would be good in this sort of deck, it's more important to cut poison guys and get a mass of poison guys. So, looks like, as much as I don't really like the deck, it seems like it's open, so time to hop on. Alright, and the trend continues with a poison card and a bunch of garbage, so I think I'm happy enough with how we ended up here. I think Molder Beast has its place in some poison decks, but here I'd rather just take the Black Leaf Goblin, both for signaling and because, might run it. If I've got enough removal spells, Black Leaf Goblin does the job just as well as Cisbear, though obviously Cisbear is much better. And I'll still take the Goblin, although the Archers does have a place in some poison decks, mostly in the sideboard, but it is a formidable card. Here, let's go into cost sort. So we've gotten quite a few 4-drops, though. If we get the better 4-drops, we can always just cut the goblins, since I'd much rather have Tel'Jalad Fallens or whatnot. Well, the pick here is clearly Memoricide. I mean, what if they have a Contagion Engine you can't beat? You've got to take the Memoricide. And Withstand Death and a bunch of blanks. Sadly, didn't wheel like Plague Stinger or Ikraclaw. I mean, that pack is going to make pack 2 probably a little weak just because passed a ton of, this is the pack with all the poison guys. Might want to splash blue, who knows. passing all those poison guys, that one pack is going to make pack 2 a little weak, but I think we can live with that. I'll take the Scrap Diver. I mean, I think the guy to our left is probably blue anyway. Blue or poison, one of the two, are probably the next two people, so don't really need to pass a Scrap Diver Serpent, and who knows, might lose to it. All right. Hoping for Contagion Engine just like, any other deck. Jeez, now this is a pack. well, as good as Mere Battle Spear is, I'd rather have the 4-drop bomb than the 7-drop bomb. So I'm going to go ahead and take Skin Render, especially since poison decks tend to be pretty fast. And looks like we're on our way, so... Yep, taking Skin Render, shipping Mere Battle Spear. Probably not wheeling anything out of this pack, though. Let's see. Mere Battle Spear, Spell Bomb, Spider, Culling Dias, Leaden Mirror. Nah, probably not. I mean, maybe like a Nihil Spell Bomb or something. But either way, I'll take a Skin Render and be happy. And then I'll take... Jeez. Well, looks like Grasp of Darkness. I like Grasp more than Plague Stinger. Especially when you're not trying to cut... Like, the guy to our right isn't going to be poisoned, so we don't really need to cut it that much. And removal spell is a removal spell. Especially since this gives us Trigon, Rustic, Skin Render, Tangling on Grasp, and we can do a pretty good job of playing Poison Control also. Guy took a rare past all these Poison cards, which could be good news. We will see in a pack or two. Alright, well, Cisbear, and that is. Looks like the Poison Signal kind of went unheeded, which is all for the best for us. And then there's not a whole lot here, but an Instill Infection, since, you know, Mize. Nothing else we're going to take. I think this pack's been fantastic so far, so even if we don't get much more than this, I would consider it a success. At this point, Galvanic Blast does not look splashed here, since we've got, you know, a solid black-green core and no mana fixing yet, but you never know. And things dry up. Does not look like a liquid metal coating deck since we don't have any pro artifact guys. Oop, Nimble Mongoose. Talk to him a little later. There's a Corrupted Harvester, Painful Quandary. I'll just take the Harvester. I mean, he's a card we're not going to play almost assuredly. Alright, as much as like Azuri Renegade Leader as a beater, Untamed Might seems like the call here. Don't have any of the evasion guys yet. But it's still fine on, like, Blight Mamba or what have you. Alright, every now and then a guy gets through. I think we've got enough removal that we'd rather have more another Poison guy, especially given the Untamed Might. So I'm going to take the Blight Mamba over to Fume Spitter here, though I think it is a close pick. But with this, before that, we only had 7 Poison guys, 2 of which were Black Cleave Goblins. So if we're going to kill our opponent with Poison, we've got to, you know, start taking Poison guys. Jeez, that's a late Ichor Claw Mirror, but never looked a Gift Mirror in the mouth or... something like that. And unsurprisingly, we did not wheel anything. Take the Spell Bomb. Since who knows, we might wheel that Throne of Geth, although that's not incredibly likely. Did wheel a Blight Mamba, which makes it very unlikely someone directly to our left was playing Poison, though. That doesn't really matter anymore, since, you know, they don't affect us anymore. I guess of all these cards, I'd be least likely to play, or least want to play against random 2-2? I don't know. Sure, I'll take Big Hops. And I've seen Bluntly Assault win games before, as unlikely as that seems. And who knows, Turnicide could be good against us. And... not nearly as exciting a pack as the last one, but at least there's a Sovok Replica. Trigon Corruption's decent, so is Fume Spitter, but Sovok Replica's going to be much better than either of those, especially since we have a ton of 4-drops and have no real artifact removal except for Rustic. So, Sovok Replica it is. This pack should be pretty good for Poison, since it was completely open pack 1. Alright, Sovok Replica is good, but Slice and Twain is an upgraded version, now that damage doesn't stack. It's pretty hard to get a 2-for-1 with this guy, but getting a 2-for-1 with Slice and Twin is, well, very easy, so. We'll take more removal. Go ahead and hide this Galvanic Blast. I don't think this is making it in. And I'll leave the Black Cleave Goblins for now. Again, if you kill all their guys, you don't really, it doesn't really matter what you kill them with. Well, I really do like Acid Whip Spider, but again, this is not... I mean, it's a control-ish deck, but I'd still rather, I think, take Sylvok Replica. There's no reason to not take more removal, especially since if there aren't very many Poison Drafters, all the rest of the decks are going to be, you know, filled with artifacts. I don't need Leaden Mirror in this deck. Carrion Call's nice and all, but I'd rather just take, Sylvok Replica. Get our removal in. Could use some more Poison Beaters, but it's not look like that's going to happen anytime soon. Not a fan of really much of this stuff. I mean, I guess Sovok Lifestyle It's going to upgrade our Blight Mambas, which is pretty good. And it's pretty good on Silvok Replica, too. Yeah, Silvok Lifestaff looks like the pick. No, I'd rather Silvok Lifestaff a Blight Mamba than Bladed Pinions it. And Teljaw Defiance is cute, but yeah. Lifestaff looks like it's going to make it in, so. Alright, well, Teljaw Fallen is better than Blackcleave Goblin, but I'd really rather just have a Slice and Twine, since removal, 2-for-1 removal spells are pretty awesome. I don't think, again, killing them is going to be that hard, and yeah, I'll just 2-for-1 them over and over again. Alright, well, there's a poison guy. He's no Cyst Bearer, but he's still a Contagious Nim. Is, yeah, going to do the job, backed up by our, you know, 7 removal spells or what have you. Definitely better than Painsmith. Don't really have anything to taint it strikes. So. Taint striking Silvok Replica is not exactly the plan I intend to have. Alright, well, one mirror ought to be good, I think. Don't need a second life staff as much as I need a first mirror, especially now that I picked up a bunch more 4-drops, so. Alright, one more pick to get, you know, like, just nothing, not too greedy, just a Plague Stinger or something. Oh. Well, Verdine Revel actually might just be the business. I've got 4 direct artifact removal spells, and plus a Skin Render, and a Grasp of Darkness, and an Instill Infection, and a Trigon, so. I could see siding it in. I don't think I'd want to main deck it, but I could definitely see siding it in if the situation warranted it. Plus, it's not like I'm gonna need a quarter shield to put on my Blight Mamba. So the question is, what I'd rather have Wing Puncture for the sideboard, or hate a Moriak Reaver that could be annoying against our Cyst Bear. And I don't really care if people play Moriak Reaver against us, and I'm certainly not gonna play it, so. Might as well take the Wing Puncture, which I'm also probably not gonna side in since I have so much removal already. Here, now I'll take the Moriak Reaver. So hiding the Reaver and the Wing Puncture, we have 17 land plus a mirror. It seems like a good mana ratio, especially since we kind of top out at 4, although Untamed Might and Trigon both don't mind having a few more mana. Again, just take the Reaves. And don't want our opponents threshing us. So yeah, I think I like the way this ended up. Yeah, I mean, it would be better if I had a Petrifax instead of the Galvanic Blast I'm not playing, but this deck's controllish enough that it doesn't really even care all that much. There's actually no chance I'm playing Tainted Strike, right? I've just got a Skin Render, so I'd better take Seize the Initiative, since that card can be annoying. Alright, now I'll take the Tainted Strike. So Poison dried up pretty bad in Pack 3, but in exchange we got a bunch of Slice and Twins and Silvok Replicas, which I can't really complain about, so. Let's go ahead and build. Alright. Unsurprisingly, the 23 cards I've laid out are the exact 23 I talked about during the draft, since I didn't really hide anything that could make it in. I mean, I guess there's a Withstand Death here, but that's a lot better with the 3-1 guys instead of Blight Mambas. So now we end up with, let's see, we have 16 guys and 5 of them don't poison. So we ended up with 11 poison guys and then Lifestaff and Untamed Might and then a bunch of removal spells, so. Yeah, I like the way this deck ended up. I think it ended up quite well. And, yeah, I don't really see any reason to play any of these other cards over any of the cards in the main, so all that we have to do now is, the curve's good too, is figure out the piles by color with Copper Mirror and the 2 Silvok Replicas and the Trigon somewhat impacting things. Looks like we're still in Zendikar lands. Alright. 9-8 in favor of black. Yeah, that seems fine. I've got 4 double black cards plus the Trigon and then the 8 forests plus the copper mirror, and then with a couple double green cards, so I guess that's that.